Hello traders, hello everyone. My name is Grigor Horvat and welcome to a new free video analysis in which I will give you my short-term outlook for stocks and also we look at dollar Chinese yuan and the Aussie dollar. But before we go to the wave counts, let me look at this total put call ratio. And what I see here is that actually put call ratio is coming down to these extreme levels, extreme readings, meaning that there are less and less shorts in the market, and always because everyone are obviously focusing and buying calls because they expect that market will continue even higher, which actually makes sense in uptrend. But if you see market moving into some very extreme readings, then actually this may cause the opposite direction or at least a pullback. Now if I look for the past price action, what has happened here is we never got any serious bearish development when put call ratio moved to this lower extreme levels, but maybe cause just temporary setbacks on maybe on intraday charts or just small percentage of a drop before market continues to the upside. So maybe we cannot expect anything significant, but at least a pullback. Before we go to the S&P 500 wave count, let me also take a look at the emerging markets. Now, emerging markets are here placed in a very big triangle. As I see it here on this is a weekly chart. It's a five-way pattern. It's a sideways price action. A, B, C, D, and E. And it looks like that we are now placed in a wave C. Now, this wave C can also, be made by five waves to the downside if you think we are in a flat and then we will recover. But I always try to focus on minimum expectations. Minimum expectations are three wave of decline. So even if I'm expecting a five wave fall, or if the market will unfold five waves to the downside, you will still firstly see a three wave move from the highs as a first part of that five wave development. And even if you're focusing just on basic technical analysis and ignore the Elliott waves theory, you would still expect that market, if turns from the upper side of the range, like in our case, you would expect that price will come to the downside, to the lower side of the range, which is this trend line. So for now, I'm just focusing on this potential drop, further weakness for wave C. So if we take a look on a daily chart to have a better and clearer view here, you can see that market here made quite nice move to the downside. It can be counted in five waves for a wave A. And then you have this recovery. This recovery appears to be very complex and looks like that market is trying to form a top here at the upper side of this range of this corrective channel, and that's a perfect characteristics when you try to identify end of this correction. So I would not be surprised if this market really tries to send us lower here. So what this may mean for the US stock market? Well, notice that from late of 2018, you can see that this market has been in recovery mode. And at the same time, we have seen a recovery here on the US stocks as well. So if we'll see here a drop, maybe this will not cause any big damage to the S&P 500, but at least maybe a pullback would be expected before we see a new leg to the upside, okay? So now let's take a look on the S&P 500 wave counts. And what you can see here, let me just find this chart. Okay, I posted this on this 2020 Elliott Wave video outlook. It was free, by the way. If you didn't find it, just you can find it for free on YouTube. You will know that I've highlighted a very strong bullish case here for this year for the S&P 500. I'm expecting a five wave development here. Within a higher degree wave 5, but looks like that this current wave 3, okay, can be coming to an end. So this is what I'm talking about potential fourth wave retracement. So looking here on the, this is alternate count, on the 4-hour chart here, you can see that market actually moved here into some very nice fib levels up there, okay? You can count waves 1, you have wave 2, you have extended wave 3, you have wave 4, and you're now making wave 5, moving nice, very nicely into this potential projections for end of a wave 5 of 3. So ideally, we will see a pullback and then move to the upside. Now, when it comes to trading, I'll definitely would not be shorting stocks or any market at the highs. What I want to see, if I want to participate on the short side, I want to see firstly a very strong drop in 5 waves, maybe on a smaller time frame, to make sure that the top is really in, because otherwise you cannot know where the top will be formed, right? You're just gambling for potential top. So it's very important for me to wait on a proper price action. That would be a 5-wave drop on a smaller time frame. Even better is just to avoid potential shorts and just be ready for potential buying opportunity in uptrend, and that would be definitely this upcoming 4th wave. So you just wait on this formation maybe to unfold. Maybe this 4th wave will show from here, maybe from higher levels, who knows. But the very important thing is that you don't trade against the trend, and definitely not in a 4th wave, because it's a corrective movement, right? And you don't want to be trapped in some sideways consolidation. So saying that, despite this potential my risk off view for the next maybe a few days, few weeks, who knows, I don't want to look, as I said, on the S&P 500. I want to look at correlated markets, which are already showing some bearish setups. So what I have in mind is Japanese yen crosses, okay? Some of them are very bearish already now, despite S&P 500 trading at resistance. So now imagine what may happen to Japanese yen if stocks really could come a little bit lower. I think that yen could see much more strength here. So my focus is on CAD yen, okay? Also because of crude oil prices. Crude oil came very sharply to the downside, maybe will stay bearish for a longer period of time. So definitely Canadian dollar has been hit hard, and this is obviously also seen through currencies. So what I see here is actually a very nice breakdown here out of this uptrend. So it looks like this recovery, which I called as a 7-swing correction, ABC, is completed. But what is the most important thing is that this market fell quite sharply through this trend line support. And you can actually see that this was just one leg of a drop. So even if I think that market will make just a temporary drop, you still need wave C, right? So I think that's a very nice potential price action that will cause even more weakness. I'm looking here at the 4-hour chart, where I count this first drop in very nice 5 waves. And then you have a 3-wave correction that now stopped at the first potential resistance. It's a 50% retracement. And also you have this 61.8% projection of wave A measured from end of wave B. Then you have this former wave 4. Okay, that's the first resistance. The second resistance that also I think can be important, especially if we see another jump on stocks and dollar yen, then maybe we will see CAD yen moving into second resistance here around 83.50. Here we have the 61.8% and the equality level of wave C compared to wave A at the 4th wave of 2 lesser degrees. Okay, so I think that both levels are very important and could cause more weak and could cause a potential turning point. So definitely I'm expecting this CAD yen to see a breakdown, especially if stocks will really see this pullback into a 4th wave from the current resistance levels. Okay, so now let's take a look on another two markets, which is dollar Chinese yuan, which has been hit hard, as you know, because of coronavirus. So where is this? Okay, here. So what I see here is actually I would not be surprised if this coronavirus would not be ending anytime soon, at least on the price data, or at least if economic data would probably not be shiny in the upcoming months for China. So I would not be surprised if dollar Chinese yuan will continue even higher. So what I'm looking at here is actually I shared this chart also in our Elliott Wave 2020 video outlook, and I said that market could see a bounce here into wave 5 And so far, we have seen a very nice reversal higher. And also notice that here, this reversal, actually on a daily chart, is looking like an impulse. And now you have a pullback here. And this impulse took us back into this wave B area. So I even see potential head and shoulders pattern here that could be building this bottom. Okay, so I'd not be surprised if we see market breaking to the upside, especially when this trend line will also be broken. Okay, at the same time, what may happen with Aussie? Well, I think that Aussie dollar could come even lower, which is, by the way, in bearish trend. So I have here Aussie dollar inverted, or dollar versus Aussie if you want, and you can see that this market actually Aussie hit the highs even before dollar Chinese yuan found the lows. Okay, so I see Aussie in a very strong downtrend, meaning that if dollar Chinese yuan could really see more upside, I think that Aussie dollar will see a lot more weakness because it's already acting very weak. So I see some potential supports a little bit lower, maybe for dollar Chinese yuan, and then I would be expecting a bounce here, which would obviously cause more upside for Aussie dollar. And looking at the wave counts on Aussie, I see a very nice decline here. It looks like that now we could be stopping here into fourth wave. Maybe we are in a wave four of a smaller degree still, or already in a wave four of a higher degree. But in either case, I would be expecting a drop away from this current resistance, okay, which actually held the prices down for a few times already. So I would be expecting this market to continue lower as long as we are trading below this invalidation level here at 0.6850, let's say. Okay, so Aussie, I think it has a very nice bearish price action which may continue to the downside with no problem, especially if the dollar Chinese yuan would actually bounce. Okay, sorry guys, it looks like that I have coronavirus as well. Anyway, traders, thank you very much for your attention. I hope that you enjoyed this video. If you're not our member yet, make sure to check our trial. We have a 7-day trial for FX or cryptocurrencies, which are on the move, by the way. So if you want to check any daily updates, make sure to tune in. Okay, first, thank you very much and have a good day. Bye.